Hello, my name is Chinon Maria. Many people call me Chichi. I am an artist and a muralist who specializes in large-scale public art installations, as well as being a teacher. I wanted to take some time today to speak to all of you about art, murals, and the power of public art. I grew up here in Vermont, but I have lived and worked in many places, including New York City, Montana, Colombia, France, and Germany. For the past 15 years, I've dedicated my life to the arts, making art with kids, making art in places that need to heal, and creating work that brings attention to important humanitarian causes. Many of my murals have bright colors, bold patterns, faces, and flowers. I've partnered with over 50 schools, 5,000 kids, and painted murals throughout the United States, South America, and Europe. I've partnered with organizations and companies like the United Nations, Make-A-Wish Foundation, B Corporation, Rotary Club, the Port Authority of New York City, Galleries Lafayette, Saks Fifth Avenue, Toyota, and the Downtown Alliance in New York City, and many more. To understand more of the work I have done, I would like to share with you a few short interviews I have done over the years. We are the duos behind Sokoki Studios. My name is Chinon Maria and
I'm Sebastian Mitre.
And we are here today because we are painting a mural 30 feet high in the sky at the future home of Two World Trade Center. Okay. Wonderful. Perfect. Okay. We're doing the outlining right now of the major pieces of the mural. And then tomorrow, what are we doing tomorrow?
Tomorrow we're starting with the fun part to apply colors and everything. So this area is going to look amazing. The power of art to change landscapes in our beloved New York City.
Already you can sort of see what's happening with what we just did. It looks great.
So as you can see, there's a little bit of Chinon Maria mischief there, already taking over the beautiful financial district full of roses and flowers. So we're excited.
I like the, actually, to be honest, how this is so linear with the Oculus. It held out for us, woohoo! What a vision to create all this. Wow.
Look at that. Wow.
During the daytime, I'll be able to see it so much clearer too. That's awesome.
The beginning.
This sort of boxy one is too where we're working now. The future home of the tower. This used to be all water. We're standing.
Right. That is so true.
Innovation at its best. So this has been a really amazing experience being on the World Trade Center campus. It first started off a little over a year ago. We were at 4 World Trade on the 69th floor. From then, I continued down to a base level being at 5 World Trade Center, where Sebastian Mitre and I completed Mural to Unite, which is a 220-foot wall with the UN Refugee Agency and the Downtown Alliance in New York City.
I'm
Such an amazing part of New York. This is our last day of installing a pretty large piece. We are very excited to bring some happiness, lots of roses and flowers, and the first time in the history of the World Trade Center that legal street art has been performed on an actual building. So Lower Manhattan is officially in full bloom, baby. Hopefully this breaks the ice for everyone who walks by here, can be inspired, can feel united, can feel happy and joyful, and it'll put a smile on their face every time that they walk through here. Meet Chinon Maria, this morning's artist in residence. Chinon is just one of a group of street artists leaving their mark on one of New York City's most hallowed sites, as Faith Saley is about to show us.
It's not uncommon to see that people in New York City have left their mark on the side of a building until you realize where that building is. More than 20,000 square feet of corrugated metal. Every surface tells a story of mystery, acceptance, love. This story, painted by artists Chinon Maria and Sebastian Maitre, blooms audaciously in the shadow of the 9/11 memorial.
You know, the flowers strike me not just as feminine, but also suggestive of new life and hope in an area that's had so much tragedy.
You want to do something that honors the area, that brings hope, that brings life to a place that has gone through such tragedy.
That is a key word, rebirth.
Reviving this site, one can of spray paint at a time, even from 30 feet in the air.
I love that this is your studio.
I know, isn't that crazy?
Your atelier.
It brings life, it brings zest, it brings activity. It brings a feeling of togetherness, it brings a feeling that hey, we're part of something that's wonderful.
For developer Larry Silverstein, the images that bathe his buildings illustrate just how far he's come.
You purchased the Twin Towers weeks before September 11th?
6 weeks before September 11th.
And how much further he has to go. The art project started when earlier this year, the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey asked Silverstein to liven up his construction zone.
You could have hired anyone. Why did you choose street art?
Maybe because it was the coolest kind of art we could find. And I'm saying this to you as an 87-year-old guy.
What is it, Larry? What's cool?
It's this art. Look at it, enjoy it, take from it, and be blessed by it.
Decades ago, businesses would never want someone spray painting their construction sites, right? That would be vandalism. And you're going out and buying the spray paint cans for these artists.
I'm saying y'all come.
The things that we previously were scared about, we now embrace for its beauty.
Alejandro Velasco teaches an art and politics course at New York University.
The question is, how can we preserve the aesthetics without losing some of its politics? That's the real challenge of street art in the 21st century.
And it's social media, say artists Sticky Monger, Boogie, and Todd Gray, that's helping spread the popularity of this newest public palette.
The pictures that they take with it, they jump with it there, the action, the motions that they give, it's everybody's artwork. We all made it together.
Still, for all the joy their art brings, the artists say they haven't forgotten their canvas is hallowed ground.
to have all these murals, they're like these metaphors of wildflowers just kind of growing through the rubble.
And you think about the location and how it is our job to really focus in and create something to respect all the lives that were lost and to know that there is hope and there is a way for us to all unite together. And that is through the art.
Does art heal?
Absolutely.
Yes, yeah. Art what? Heals.
In so many ways.
Yes, it does.
Mind, body, and soul.
There are other signs. Big art is on the rise, even outside the World Trade Center, where Shinon Maria is working on a 200-foot mural.
We have over 42 gallons of paint in this project.
Surrounded by the rhythm of rebuilding.
Welcome to New York City. If there's not construction happening on one block, then you're in the wrong spot.
Beyond the work I've done at the World Trade Center, I've made many other murals throughout the United States as well as in South America and in Europe. At the end of the day, the work I love most are projects where I can work with a community or school and share my love for art. Public art is powerful. I've seen firsthand how it has the ability to heal, unite, and also empower people and communities. When you give the opportunity for people to become involved in the process of art making, especially something large scale, the impact can be really compelling. Coming together and creating something as a community is empowering, especially when it is something that may still be there even after you are gone. I hope that together we can create a mural that you can all feel proud of and feel the pride you have for your school. I'm looking forward to meeting all of you very soon. Thank you. Bye-bye.